Christmas, when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads.
Granny,
and Mama in
Granny,
her
stop.
Kerchief,
Granny,
and I
Granny,
in my cap,
Granny,
and just said,
Granny,
what?
Granny, I have a question.
I'm reading the story.
Well,
to
I know, but I have a question.
What?
What's a sugar plum?
Well, funny you should ask.
Hi everyone, and Merry Christmas! It's John, and Ben couldn't be here today, but I do have a special guest for a very special Christmas video. Creepy Granny's here. Hi, Granny!
Hello! Hello! Hi, everybody!
Granny, how's it going this year?
Oh, I'm doing great! How are you?
I'm doing excellent. Remember last year I invited you over and we did that video where we made figgy pudding together?
Yes, and that figgy pudding was quite tasty.
And I thought
are we gonna make it again?
No figgy pudding this time.
Oh.
But,
yes.
But Granny.
What?
Granny, guess what?
What?
Well, I thought I'd keep the tradition alive, and you know, thinking back to these treats that you hear about in poems and songs and stories from olden times, I thought I would make sugar plums this year. You know, like in the night before Christmas? You know, the sugar plums are dancing in the children's heads.
Oh. Oh, okay.
Have you ever had a sugar plum?
No, I have not.
See, you weren't very crazy about figgy pudding last year either.
No, I was not.
It wasn't.
No. But hey!
Hey,
you
something
know?
New. Maybe you could send a few to Chad Allen. I hear you two are kind of a thing right now. That's what they're saying on the internet.
Don't get me started! With him.
How's Creepy Twilight doing? She doesn't seem like her old self lately.
No, she doesn't, she's not doing so well right now. She's missing Creepy Teddy.
So, that's sad. Is she gonna do a Christmas vlog?
I don't think so. I think she's just not right in the Christmas spirit this year, so...
I don't believe it.
I don't think she's actually gonna do a vlog.
Well, maybe some of these sugar plums will help cheer her up. Let's go to the kitchen.
Okay.
Let's go. Come on. Let's go.
All right, John, you ready?
I'm ready for this. Are you ready, Granny?
I'm ready.
Okay, so the things we need are 6 ounces of slivered almonds, toasted, 4 ounces of dried plums, 4 ounces of dried apricots, 4 ounces of dried figs.
What is it with all these recipes and figs?
1/4 of a cup of powdered sugar. We're also going to need some ground cardamom. Did I say that right, Granny?
Yeah. I don't know. Let me look at that. Looks right to me.
We're going to need some caraway seeds.
Toasted.
And some fennel seeds.
Toasted.
A pinch of salt.
That looks like more than a pinch to me, but I'm not putting all that in there. Holy
No, Granny. Just a pinch out of this jar. 1/4 of a cup of honey. And 1 cup of coarse sugar.
That doesn't look coarse to me. I think that's just granulated.
Well, we gotta make do with what we have, Granny.
Oh, great. I don't think it's gonna matter. It'll make it extra sugary. Well, I think we should probably toast up our almonds and all of those seeds before we get going, don't you think?
Let's toast these almonds, Granny.
Toasted almonds. Yeah, flatten them all out so they're about one layer high.
They look like those little potato sticks.
They do. I don't think they taste like them, though.
Now, Granny, I gotta warn you, I couldn't find these anise seeds. I don't know if I'm even saying this right. A-N-I-S-E seeds. So I'm just gonna put in an extra 1/4 teaspoon of one of these seeds. That sound good to you?
Yeah, I think that'll work fine.
Look at these big jars of seeds I had to buy just to use that much in this recipe.
You never know, you might like it, and maybe you'll make them every year, and then you'll be happy you have a big old jar.
Look at those little seeds. It won't take too long to toast that itty bitty bit of seeds.
No, I don't think so. I think that'll be good.
I put in a little bit extra, just a teeny hair extra, to make up for our lack of the other seeds.
Yeah, good idea. Okay, check on those almonds while you're over there, Sonny.
Our almonds are all toasted. I put them in this little bowl here. We're gonna add those to the food processor.
All right.
Along with our plums. Here they are right here. In they go.
Whoa!
Whoa!
Hold your plums!
are apricots.
Yes, we need those apricots.
They're going in.
That's quite the interesting. How are these called sugar plums when you have all this other stuff in there?
Oh. There we go. And of course, our figs have to go in. Can't have one of these holiday recipes without figs, right, Granny?
Yeah, you obviously have to have figs ready. They must have had an overabundance of figs back in the day when they made all these ingredients.
Okay, now we put the lid on. Do you want to do the honors, Granny? We got to pulse this 20 to 25 times or until fruit and nuts are chopped into small pieces, but before the mixture becomes a ball. Okay, Granny, you ready to do the honors?
I'll try.
Okay, you need a little hand with those hooves of yours?
Yeah.
Okay, here's pulse. Ready?
Some more chopping to do. Okay, here's your bowl.
Okay, so we need the powdered sugar.
Yep. Woo!
And our seeds, which are all toasted. They didn't take long to toast, did they, Graham?
No, they didn't. Not at all. I didn't think so with that itty bitty little amount.
I didn't want them to burn, so there go the seeds.
Okie dokie.
And our cardamom, which we need 1/4 of a teaspoon of that, too. There we go. Do you think Tegan will like sugar plums, Granny?
Well, I don't think he needs any more sugar.
Granny, smell that. Smell that cardamom. Don't sneeze. Oh, Granny. Here we go.
Okie dokie. That's probably why you just use a little itty bitty bit.
And a pinch of salt. Remember my pinch?
Yeah, you're not going to put that whole thing in there, are you?
No, it's a pinch, Granny.
Okay, good.
Okay. You think that's a pinch? This right here? Bam.
I didn't even see any go in there.
Now we add in the nut and fruit mixture and the honey.
Oh, honey!
And mix using gloved hands until well combined. So I gotta reach in there and go like, but I don't have any gloves.
Uh-oh! You better wash those hands!
Here comes the fruit and nut mixture into our sugar and spice and everything nice. You see what I did there?
Yeah, real funny.
There we go. It comes out pretty easily, doesn't it, Granny?
Yeah! Whoa.
Granny, have you ever had sugar plums before?
Well, actually...
It sounds like, you know, that poem must be as old as you are, so I just
say... Excuse me!
We're gonna put in our honey.
Honey! I love honey. John's washing his hands right now.
Hi, Tegan.
You ready? Hello, little man.
And Granny was a witness that I did indeed wash my hands, even though I don't have the gloves that they recommend.
Yes, you did. He did wash his hands. I heard him.
I'm going to have some sticky paws.
Yeah, you are. You better not come near me. You know how hard it is to get my hair perfect like this every single day?
Here we go.
Alrighty.
Because all that stuff, all the seeds and stuff are in the bottom.
Yeah, you probably should have done that the other way around, huh?
I was following the directions.
That's true, you were. You were following the directions.
Would you ever get this done if Twilight was here?
Absolutely not. You know how many questions she'd be asking me? I wouldn't be able to get anything done.
What do you think, Granny?
Ew. Well, it does not look very good, but, you know, the figgy pudding last year didn't look very good either, but it was really yummy.
All right, Granny, so I don't have a scoop small enough to get the exact size, so I'm just going to wing it and roll them out by hand.
Okay, why is your son poking me in the eye? Off.
They kind of look like little meatballs.
They do look like little meatballs. They better not taste like... I know what meatballs do to you.
Okay, Granny, now there are two ways. Where's my recipe?
I don't know where your recipe went.
If we're serving these immediately, we can roll them in the sugar.
Okay.
It says on here, the sugar plums may be stored on the cooling rack for up to a week. After a week, store in an airtight container for up to a month.
Oh my goodness gracious!
We could be eating these right into the new year. So Granny, for a little tasty test, you want to roll one of these in sugar and see how it is?
Okay! Now I believe the these are supposed to sit for 13 hours and then roll them in the sugar, you know, to actually let everything sit. But we're going to just see if everything tastes okay.
And then when we're done, we'll show our finished sugar plums.
Sugar.
There we go. You want to try that, Granny? All right, about to pop in my first ever sugar plum. Granny, what was your review?
Not very sugary. It was very, very dry fruity.
All right, let me roll it. I'm going to roll it again. Okay, here we go. First ever sugar plum. Not bad.
Not bad.
Mm.
But I thought I was going to taste a little bit more sugar.
I don't know if it'd be dancing around in my head, though.
No.
We just leave them on the counter for 13 hours.
Oh, Granny. I thought they were in the fridge for 13 hours.
No, we just let them sit here.
Well, I think your son wants some.
We're going to put these up, and we'll check back in 13 hours. Maybe they harden up a little bit more.
I'm going to go wash the soaps.
Granny, are you still here? Wake up, Granny. Did you fall asleep watching your TV shows?
I did. I still don't know what happened to Glenn.
All right. Anyway, our sugar plums have sat for 13 hours, and you can see what they look like here.
They look the same as they did before they sat for 13 hours. You sure it was 13 hours? Were you paying attention?
So you're supposed to warm them up a little by, you know, do this.
Roll them around in your hands.
Yep.
Okay.
And then we're going to roll them in the sugar.
Okay.
Look at that, guys.
It looks like a little snowball.
It does. Now look how many of these we have to do.
Well, you better get to work and...
Why did I invite you over? You really haven't done anything except complain.
My cheery disposition.
There we go, Granny. Check them out.
What kind of a... Holy smokes, you made a mess.
Well, and we're going to put them in this festive holiday tin.
Okay.
And give them out to all our friends and family members. Don't you think they'll like these?
I don't know.
Here we go. Finished sugar plums.
I'm having a hard time finishing this. Hold on a second.
They're very chewy, aren't they, Granny?
Not really. I know there's a whole bunch of ingredients in there because I was with you when we made it, but that just tastes like the inside of a fig Newton.
Well, that was fun, Granny. Now we can both say we've tried a sugar plum.
Yes, we can.
And I think the reviews are a little mixed. They aren't terrible.
No, they're not bad. They're just, you know, I think I like candy better.
I don't think Reese's Peanut Butter Cups existed when they wrote The Night Before Christmas.
No, probably not.
These were probably the equivalent of Reese's Peanut Butter Cups back in the 1800s.
Maybe. Let's hope so.
Those poor kids,
if this is all they got for sweets, I feel bad for them.
I'm still picking it out of my teeth.
My dentures did pop out for a minute, but I got them back in. And you know, I liked them, but they tasted like the inside of a fig Newton. Without the, like, cracker around the outside to kind of dull it down.
Would these be dancing in your head tonight, Granny?
No, not unless they give me heartburn. Then they'll be dancing in my head. That is not a very good thing to be doing on camera, you know.
Well, I got it stuck in my teeth, Granny. So we have a tin full of these to hand out to our family and friends. I don't think they'll particularly care for them. Would Creepy like some of these?
Probably not.
Well, anyway, yeah, I think I'm with you, Granny. I think I like the figgy pudding a little bit better. I know you mentioned that off camera.
Oh, I like the figgy pudding. Yeah, that was good. Out of the oven.
We should have made that this year. You know, next year, I wonder what we could make. You know, there's also, you know, chestnuts roasting on an open fire, you know. Wouldn't that be fun?
I don't think you should be allowed around open fire.
Another traditional holiday feast from back in the day, like back in the 1800s that I found on Google, was pig's head with mustard. Do you want to try to make that next year? Granny?
Well, I gotta go.
Granny, come
nice
back.
Nice to see you.
Granny. Come here, Granny. Come here. We're going to wish everybody out there happy holidays, okay? Where are you, Granny? There we go.
La 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 la. Merry Christmas.
Granny.
I'm okay.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Hope it was a good one.
Oh.
We'll see you next year as Granny and I make pig's head with mustard.
No! You're on your own on that one. I'm not doing that.
Granny, have you seen Star Wars yet? You wouldn't believe what happens to... Granny!